Hello, and today we're with Mr. Alejandro Bernabe, who is the Group Director of Avani Hotels and Resorts. Good afternoon to you, Alejandro.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
Now, Avani, we've actually sat in the flagship Avani Hotel, which is the one in Bangkok, the Avani Riverside Bangkok.
Correct.
A year ago, I interviewed Christian, the general manager here at the hotel. At that stage, the hotel was just about to open. How has the first year of this property been?
It's been amazing. I think that we have all been extremely positively surprised by the occupancy that the hotel has reached, by the type of clientele that is coming, by the reviews that we are getting. So it's been a fantastic year.
Where are the guests coming from?
We are getting a mix. A lot of guests are coming from Thailand, from Bangkok, for coming for groups as well, from Asia, China, Korea, Japan, and also Australia and Europe. So it's a mixed bunch of guests.
In terms of the age group, because, well, in fact, let me ask you first of all, you have the two brands at the moment in terms of Anantara and Avani, which are sat next to each other,
yes.
The Anantara Riverside Bangkok and the Avani Riverside Bangkok. For you briefly, how do those two brands differ?
They are completely different. I think that Anantara is a brand that is focusing on luxury, on experiences, on being the indigenous. Avani is a lot more for the millennial mindset, not younger people, but younger way of thinking, people that don't want to spend too long in the hotel. They want to be immersed in the place where they are. So they complement each other very well, more than compete.
In terms of age groups, you mentioned the markets that Avani is attracting. In terms of the age groups, how have they differed now that you've had the first year open here at Avani?
I will not be focusing too much on the age group. I will be focusing more on the type of people, because you can see here in Avani also middle age, 50, 60 years old, but they are a lot more travel savvy. You see them all with different telephones, using a lot of technology, not so much the people which are coming to spend 2 weeks in a resort. It's completely different.
What surprises have you seen over the year, things that you didn't expect, or possibly things that you have learned that you would improve on a future Avani hotel?
Things that I will improve, I don't think that we will improve. I think that we will learn from things that we have done here. This hotel is very particular because it's attached to a shopping center. So there is also a lot of restaurants, a lot of convenience stores, and maybe if we will be attached to another shopping center, we should have to adjust a little bit to the offering. But besides that, I think that the design and what we were looking for is all the elements are here.
Now, the Anantara Riverside is quite possibly the only true real resort in the city of Bangkok. An amazing property. It has a lot of people that love the property because it's such an old property. When we discussed with Christian, I was talking about the fact that the swimming pool is one of the best in the city. Have you had, what terms of issues have you had with people wanting to use that?
Me personally, I have not heard anything. I think that they are completely different pools. As I mentioned, the pools in the Anantara, they are by the river. So when you are there, you feel that you are in a resort. The pool of this hotel is magnificent as well. It's on the 26th floor. You can see the entire Bangkok from there. So it's very different. I will say probably the people of Anantara want to come to the pool here.
Now, of course, getting into the city is very important as well. And of course, you have the boats that take people to Spantax in.
Yes.
Our guests are both properties able to use them, and have you had to increase the number of boats because now you do have an extra property?
I am not sure if the number of boats were increased. I know that the frequency was increased, so you have a boat every 20 minutes. So from 6 o'clock in the morning until midnight, basically, every 20 minutes there is a boat available. So it's fantastic. I used to live on the other, or I still live on the other side of the river in Bangkok, and I never realized how much crossing the river makes a difference. It's like you're coming to a different city.
Now, expansion, because you are obviously the group director. What plans has Avani got for the future?
Well, Avani is having a very strong pipeline, and I think that over the next couple of years, it's going to grow tremendously. We have some exciting properties. We just signed a property in Busan that is going to be right in front of the biggest amusement park in Korea, the biggest outlet store in Korea. So it's going to be really, really a great Avani We are opening a resort in Thailand, in one of the islands, which will be the first pool villa resort for Avani. So it's going to be also something very different of what we have done until now. We are also looking in the Middle East. We just announced a property in Dubai, in Ibn Battuta, but there's two more properties coming in the Emirates as well. In April, we are opening the first Avani in Lisbon, in Europe. So this will give us, again, a tremendous exposure in a completely different environment where we have been. But it's a perfect Avani. It's in the best location in town, small hotel, specifically designed for the people to come to the city and explore it. So I think the pipeline for Avani, some properties as well, we're looking in Japan, we are looking in Hong Kong, we are looking in the Maldives. So very dynamic, I will say.
You mentioned the first purpose-built resort for Avani will be built in Thailand on one of the islands.
Yes.
When is that expected to open?
Beginning of next year.
And do you have other such villa, pool villa resorts scheduled for opening in the region?
Yes, we are looking at another property in Thailand, in a different island, coming a little bit later in about 2 years, because this will be a bigger property, and there will be a combination between building with hotel rooms and some pool villas as well.
In terms of these pool villas, do you envisage, for example, an Avani with only pool villas, or will it be a mix of property building and pool villas together?
I think it depends on the destination, I think it depends on the space that we have, on the clientele. The one in the south, the first one that is coming, it will be a mix. So 50% of the inventory will be pool villas, then you will have some family suites, and then you will have some rooms as well, so it will be a combination.
You mentioned the Middle East, you mentioned the UAE, where you've just signed one in Ibn Battuta, and you have also two which have not yet been confirmed in terms of the location. Which areas of the Middle East, in terms of Qatar, has the World Cup coming up? Which other areas of the Middle East, apart from the UAE, are you looking at specifically?
We are looking at Qatar, but as you know, Minor has different brands, and we need to make sure that all the brands have a space. So we decided to bring some other brands into Qatar at this moment with Tivoli. But we are looking at Bahrain. Me personally, I would love to be in Oman as well. There is Anantara already there with two properties, but I think there is enough space to have Anantara and Avani as well. I think Saudi Arabia will be a great location for Avani as well. Both, it can be in Jeddah, it can be in Riyadh, it can be in some of the other cities. Jordan, I used to live in Jordan, so I believe that a property like this will be a fantastic addition for the Jordan hospitality. Lebanon, if you look at lifestyle, definitely Beirut is probably the capital of life in the Middle East. So there is plenty of opportunities and places that we are looking at.
If we keep heading north, we get into Europe, and as you mentioned there, we mentioned Portugal. One of the first Avani is scheduled to open there. What other plans do you have for Europe and London as well, and other parts of Europe? What is happening there with Avani?
You know, to enter Europe is very difficult, so I think that we are going step by step. Hopefully, the Avani in Lisbon will be the platform to move into other destinations and to show to the European market what Avani means. So at this moment, we are concentrating more in Asia and in the Middle East. Africa, definitely, it's a huge potential for our brand. And then slowly start moving into Europe.
You obviously have a lot happening here in Thailand. Another very important source market is Australia and New Zealand. What are you doing in terms of those two markets down south?
There is a property coming in Australia very, very soon. I think it's within the next 6 months. And then we are looking at, but this will be an Avani residence.
Residence?
Yes.
So this is a serviced apartment?
This will be a serviced apartment.
Is that the first Avani serviced apartment
in the
world?
The first one.
And yes. Obviously, because this is something which, frankly, is becoming very popular now within the hotel industry, mm-hmm. Service departments. What sort of sizes are we looking at, and how will this differ from, obviously, an Avani hotel?
Well, I'm sure that you know that Minor owns Oaks in Australia, which is extremely popular. So we have seen an opportunity for bringing something a little bit more modern, a little bit more contemporary, a little bit upper scale than Oaks, and that's what we are doing there. How will it differentiate from the look and feel? I don't think that there will be much difference. I think it will be more with the service that we will provide. You will not have a lobby like in this hotel here, or a big all-day dining. It will be more a pantry, probably a gym. So it's small facilities that our residents will offer.
It's okay. So if we try and get some numbers on this, you have the hotel brand, you have, yes, Avani the hotels. What is your target by, let's say, end 2020? What is your target for hotels open, hotels in the pipeline? And also, in terms of the service residents, the service departments, Avani residences, how many do you envisage having by the end of 2020?
We are in 2017. I think at the moment we have 17 properties already under operation. So I will say by 2020, under operation, we should be around 25 properties. So there's minimum 8 properties coming. This will be all new properties. In between, there can be some takeovers, but I will not include that in the 25. In terms of residences, at this moment we are only looking at Australia at this moment, but I will think by 2020 there will be at least 4.
Within Australia?
Australia, and maybe we start looking at something outside.
How long do you think, obviously Hong Kong and Singapore, these are very exciting and very important, but also very difficult markets to get into for the hotel industry. How long do you think it will be before we have an Avani or an Avani residences in either of those two cities?
Honestly, I don't know. I know that our development team is already pursuing different opportunities with something very unique, which this is what Avani can bring to those markets. So if everything goes well, I think we will be able to announce them soon. And if not, in a couple of years, maybe we are still talking about them.
In terms of technology, this is something that a lot of hotels are playing with, different types of technology, whether it be online checking, keyless room entry, even robots delivering room service and doing other things. What is Avani's take on technology? What are you doing with technology to improve the guest experience and the back of house experience?
I think you mentioned something very important, which is using technology to improve the guest experience, not to improve the way, you know, or to minimize the amount of employees. I believe that Avani is taking the middle of the road. So if you compare to some of the luxury properties, they're very conservative, where everything has to be done through employees. No, we don't want that. But some of the cutting edge companies that they are bringing everything online and starting to change the employees with robots, we also don't want that. We believe that our employees pay an intrinsic part of the experience of the guest. We want, when the guest checks in into the hotel, that they talk to somebody so we can understand what do they want to do in the city, and hopefully we can help them. So technology, yes. I think it's imperative to have a fantastic Wi-Fi in every hotel, and of course complimentary. IPTV systems, connectivity in the rooms, USB plugs everywhere in the rooms. So all of that, it's already in the Avani properties, but we are not thinking about moving the employees and putting a robot at this moment.
Talking of employees, this is a very big issue. How do you maintain brand standards when there are so many hotels around the world opening, trying to poach your good staff? You have to open properties yourself. You've just mentioned your pipeline and your targets by end 2020. How are you keeping this, first of all, attracting staff to come and work at the hotels, and then maintaining the levels of standard that you want? And what do you do to make sure that they learn different cultures and experience the different cultures of the different properties that you have as you expand?
It's a very good question. I've worked for many years in hospitality, and I think that standards are important, but it standards can be taught. And many of the standards are there just to make your life miserable. No? I believe that the most important thing is to have people with fantastic attitude and people that they love what they are doing. If they are not passionate about their job, you can teach them all the standards that the guests will not be happy. So we are more looking at young people with passion, willing to go the extra mile, willing to take risk, than really extremely well-trained employees. The training can come later, I will say. In terms of being exposed to different cultures, well, we work in a company which is minor, which has over 160 hotels in I don't know, more than 40 countries. So there is many, many opportunities for people to experience in Avani or experience in some of the other brands as well.
Now, today you've mentioned, Alejandro, you mentioned the residences. But just one question with regard to the residences. When is the first one opening? When will it open?
It will be before end of 2017.
Before the end of 2017. So you mentioned the Avani Hotels. We discussed that a little bit, the residences. Is there any other plans for Avani to have an Avani light, a budget Avani property?
No. No, there is no plan to have an Avani light. At this moment, the portfolio that we have is a little bit mismatched because many of the properties were converted and take over. But we don't build, or we are not building the brand of Avani based on the look and feel of the property, but more on the experiences and the way we do things. And this can be replicated in any property. So, no, we are not looking at an Avani light.
With the expansion of the group, are you concentrating more on new builds, or is there a balance between new builds and takeovers or rebrands?
We are mostly concentrating on new deals. The takeovers become more an opportunistic way of growing. So we are not saying no to takeovers, but definitely we are looking at new builds.
You've mentioned resorts, a couple of islands in Thailand. Indonesia is one of the big hotspots, especially Bali, Lombok, and other parts of the country. In terms of other resorts, where are we looking at here, and how close are we to signing something?
We are definitely looking at Bali. At the moment, we don't have anything fixed. There's two projects for Anantara, and there's possibilities of maybe doing something together with Anantara. But in Sumatra, at this moment, we are pursuing a very serious lead. But this will be a city hotel. It will not be a resort hotel.
Earlier on, before we turned the camera on, we were discussing with a couple of other colleagues about how Thailand is opening up its airports. Konkan is booming. Even Ubon Ratchathani, you can now fly to different destinations. Which are some of the secondary and tertiary destinations within Thailand, possibly not resorts, but inland, that you feel Avani is a suitable product for somewhere that you haven't got a product at the moment?
Well, we are already in Konkan. As you mentioned, I'm going there tomorrow, as a matter of fact. And I believe Konkan can be a fantastic Avani. If you go to the city, I was very, very surprised by the amount of young people which are there, the amount of terraces, cafes that you have in the city. At the moment, the hotels which are in the city are a little bit old style. Very good hotels, but I would say more old-fashioned. And Avani brings a new breath of air, fresh air, into the city. So I think this will be a platform to moving into the north. I think that Chiang Mai could be a great location as well for an Avani property. So we are trying.
Alejandro, it sounds like you're going to be a very busy man, but I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today, because I know that you have a lot going on at the moment. So thank you very much for your time, and of course I wish you and Avani the best of luck for the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.